They are responding to a request from the interim president, Jankonda Traore, and religious leaders to support the country's forces, whichever way they can.
We are ready to respond to any request from our government. If it calls us to fight, we will respond. We are ready to die.
Others donated money and food to the military.
Government officials in Bamako have called the French intervention in their country's north a welcome shift in the standoff. There's also a sense of guarded optimism among people here that the operation might once again unite Mali.
I left the north after it was taken over. I'm very happy with the French intervention. I'd like the crisis to come to an end so we can go back home.
I don't see any other solution than a military one. How can you negotiate with terrorists and foreigners who have occupied our country? It's not possible.
And the man who led the coup that plunged Mali into turmoil in March last year, Captain Amadou Sanogo, visited wounded Malian soldiers in hospital.
I am telling the Malian people, thank you for your support to our national army. We have launched offensives without having any assistance, and we are happy to have the French by our side, playing a major role in the air support and operations.
Support for the operation is at its highest here. On one of Bamako's main streets, the French and Malian flags hang side by side. Traders are also doing a brisk business selling the French flag to motorists. The French have been bringing in more troops to Mali. About 100 soldiers arrived here on Sunday. They say their forces will stop the rebel advance and pave the way for the deployment of other soldiers from the West African bloc, ECOWAS.